Jimmy, Illinois State, a challenging team on the road, and to jump ahead 20-0 after a quarter, an early statement really established things from the word go.
Yeah, I was really proud of our offense. I mean, we got great running backs, but those old linemen picking that, all the stunts and the movement that Illinois State does, it was really impressive. And Mark kept it going with the throws to the Yankees, and they were in rhythm tonight, and that's why I kept going for it on fourth, because we're hard to stop for a yard.
Well, again, just the way the first quarter plays out, when you're on the road in front of a crowd that wants to give you a lot of negative energy, to establish momentum the way you did early is critical.
Yeah, it was critical, and I think the best defense is a great offense, and we came out and performed the way we were capable of, and we were hard to get off the field.
I'm just going to rattle off a stat, and I want your thoughts. 374 rushing yards by the Jackrabbits tonight.
Yeah, it was extremely impressive against that defense, who statistically is the best rush defense in FCS football, I believe, or at least in the Valley, which is the toughest conference in the country. So proud of their efforts, the push, the consistent blocking on the perimeter stayed consistent, and I don't know if there's a better running back in college football than Isaiah Davis right now.
I was going to say, the question I had for you, and you asked it of me when you first got on the headsets during break, how about Isaiah Davis?
Yeah, he's special. I mean, that long run that was called back for a touchdown. I mean, we tried to block it up, but sometimes I think we all need to just get out of his way.
Well, how about Jadon Janke as well, of course? Injury-plagued non-conference, hasn't had many opportunities, and comes up with two big touchdown grabs in the first half.
Yeah, he's a great player, and him and his brother are huge part of this offense and a huge part of this team, and today he got the ball at him and he made the most of it.
And how often have we talked about when you go on the road you have to limit your own mistakes or force the opponent into mistakes? Came up with two big turnovers tonight.
Yeah, we did, and the penalties there, I mean, we got to clean it up. Overall, it was a good game. We need to get better. I felt defensively we were chasing at times some calls, and we'll get better. We weren't never really in the flow of the game on defense, but the turnovers were huge.
Well, and Jason Freeman seemed to be all over the field. We could rattle off three or four names. Williamson had 10 stops, Reeder 8, but Freeman had 9, 6 of them solo. Special being back here in his home state tonight.
Yeah, I think all these guys that play for are from Illinois, enjoy coming back. I mean, Deshaun Gales has probably 200 people in the stands just waiting for him right now, so anytime that we can come to these kids' home state and perform the way we just did, it's a positive night.
What does it say, too, about Mark Gronowski and the way that he just handles everything thrown at him the way he played tonight?
Yeah, he's a winner. He's a winner, and he's got unbelievable poise, and I don't know if anything's ever too big for him. Whether we're up by a lot or down by a lot, it doesn't really matter to him. He's a winner.
The uniqueness of how this plays out from a special team standpoint, because there's some glaring errors, but you also get a huge turnover in that category as well.
Yeah, glaring errors. Hunter didn't kick the way he's capable of, and I know he's not proud of it. Some of those kicks, they just got away from him, and he'll get better. He won't hang his head. We're going to rely on him. That's why we went for the 41-yard field goal, and he just happened to come up short on it.
Well, a win today, and now you look forward to next week. And I know we're not into the game planning of Northern Iowa and all that, but to be home, Hobo Day, sold-out crowd, what does that mean to you?
Yeah, it's going to be unbelievable, great atmosphere, and you and I always gives us fits, so we're going to need to prepare well and come out and compete at our best.
Jimmy, congratulations.
Appreciate it. Thanks, guys.
And we'll catch up with the wide receiver from Madison, South Dakota. Jadon, first and foremost, how are you feeling?
I'm feeling great. I didn't get dinged up too bad out there. Back's a little sore, but all in all, it was a great game, and we came out pretty healthy for the most part.
For you personally, to go through the non-conference not really being able to be 100%, does it make it all the more special when you're able to do what you did tonight?
Absolutely. I think if I would have been in bounds on that one, in the back of the end zone, it would have been 3 touchdowns and 3 catches. You can't ask for much more than that. I've kind of been through a whirlwind with injuries since the national championship game. So I'm just very, very blessed and grateful to be out here again.
And talk about the relationship you have with Mark Gronowski, because you have to have trust in the quarterback, and the quarterback likewise has to trust you.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, we've lived together in the past 2 years. When Mark was on his official visit, I actually caught passes for him in front of the coaches and everything. So it started way back then, and I love that guy to death. I wish he'd throw it to me just a little bit more, but, you know, our offense is on a hot streak right now, and we're going to keep it going.
Well, I tell you what, you might have to have your brother start throwing balls to you if he's going to throw as many times as he tried to tonight.
Absolutely. He's got a questionable arm, but I'll take any passes I get.
Hey, to come on the road the way that you did today and establish dominance from the word go, what does that say about this football team?
Sorry, can you repeat that, please?
No, I understand. The band is playing right as they walk by. It's hard to hear. Yep. To come on the road to establish the way you did, score on your first five possessions in a rowdy atmosphere against a good team, what does that say about you and your squad?
I think it says a lot about us. We're very resilient, and we come in, doesn't matter where we play or who we're playing against, we go out hot. That's a big emphasis we've had this year, is starting fast and then keeping on that gas pedal the entire game. And I think we've been through the ringer in the past year or two, and we're just built for this stuff.
And Jadon, I know as important as the catches are, it's just as important you're blocking on the perimeter, and you guys helped establish things for Davis and the Johnsons and Mark. 374 rushing yards tonight.
Yes, sir.
What does that mean?
That means a lot. I know it starts up front with the big hogs, so I can't leave them out. And there was a couple of blocks that I missed, too, so I don't want to pat myself on the back too much. But I would say that we have the best blocking receiver core in the nation. And I think that says a lot about your program, is when your receivers block like we do.
Jadon, Hobo Day next week, sellout crowd. Are you excited?
I'm absolutely excited. You know, last Hobo Day for me and the rest of us six-year guys, so we're looking forward to it a lot, and we're going to come out hot just like we did today.
Jadon, thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
First off, Jason, congratulations. How are you feeling right now?
I'm good. I'm just glad to be home. You know, I played a lot of ball here in Illinois, so it's good to be back here. I got a lot of family here right now, so just trying to play my best ball in front of them. That's usually what happens, so I'm glad they're here.
That was my next question, just how special today and this week has been to know you're coming back to your home state.
Yeah, it means everything to me. You know, family's the most important thing to me. I had that at my old school. You know, when you're 8.5, 9 hours away, it's hard to do that. So being able to come back to Illinois, have all my family and friends here, it means a lot to me.
Jason, just take us through the way this first quarter plays out, where the offense scores a touchdown, you force a three and out, they score a touchdown, Illinois State fumbles on the kick return, score another touchdown. Redbirds have had three offensive snaps, and your team is ahead 20-0. What does it do to a defense when you know you've already been staked to that big of a lead?
Yeah, I always tell Zay this because I live with him. I always tell him, like, if y'all keep scoring, we going to win. So, you know, that's what they kept doing. Offense did their thing. Special teams, they showed out today. And, yeah, getting out to an early lead is always good. It just gives us momentum on both sides of the ball. We only had to play three snaps the majority of the first quarter. So that's good as a defense. You don't get too much wear and tear, stuff like that. So you're a lot fresher for those later quarters.
What is it like with a quarterback like Anikstad, who's completing a lot of passes, but they're short gains? Does it get frustrating at times? Because with how quick he gets the ball out, it's hard to get home.
Yeah, and it's just like they're chopping the wood, you know, because, you know, usually, like, you get the deep balls and they go three and out, but they just kept getting those, extending the drives on the third down, stuff like that. We had a couple bad penalties on defense, but you know, collectively, I think we played good, but obviously there's room for improvement. We shouldn't give up 20 points to any team, so just knowing that and that we won, it just shows how great we can be, and we just got to find a way to show that 1 week.
I have to ask about your roommate. All Davis did was rush for 197 yards and two touchdowns tonight.
Yeah, he's a special guy. You know, you give him that rock, he's not going to go down easy, and he just continues to show that. He has a great work ethic. He loves ball, and you can just see it how the way he plays. And I'm proud to have him as a teammate and a brother.
We talk about it all the time, Jason, but when you have a guy like Adam Bach that goes down, and you guys have gotten used to this because you had so many injuries a year ago, but it matters. But at the same time, you guys have so much confidence in whoever is on the field.
Yeah, this is that love we have with each other in the LB room. Savion does a great job stepping up, as you can see, week in and week out. He makes those plays, and I'm just super proud of him, being a close friend with him, being able to talk to him about this stuff, just knowing that, you know, when your number's called, he's going to step up, and he's continued to do that these past two seasons, so I'm super proud of him.
Last thing for you, Jason. How excited are you for next Saturday, Hobo Day, and a sellout crowd as Northern Iowa comes to Brookings?
Yes, sir. You know I love when the crowd's hype. It's everything you want in college football, you know. Hobo Days, homecoming, playing a good team, whole crowd's there turning you up. So I'm just super excited for next week. I know it's going to be a show, and defense is definitely going to put one on.
Jason, congratulations.
Appreciate you.